Well, these two teams are one game away from playing for that gold ball. It's the Division II semifinals, matching up Wanakee taking on the Windno Falcons.
Wanakee moving the ball well in the first half, and it gets the ball down to Riley Freeman, who gets the and one. Windno's Kavon Taylor had a quiet first half, but he gets this jump shot to fall. Wanakee guard Mitch Liston takes his man off the dribble, then pulls up in his face for two. He is arguably one of the best sophomores in the state. Tyler Hero goes coast to coast, gets the layup, plus the foul. We move to the second half, and Warriors forward Riley Freeman is still putting in work on the block as he gets the skyhook to drop. The green light went off for Kavon Taylor in the second half. He drills this three. He drops 17 points in the half. Windno would double-team Freeman late in the second half, but he will find the open man, Mitch Liston, who connects on the three, and Wanakee wins 62-59. Now let's listen in to Windno after the game.
Getting up here, weren't satisfied, wasn't the result we're looking for, but certainly there'll be a lot of expectations next year. That's going to be another challenge for us, is how to handle being one of the top teams in the state next year.
We'll work hard in the summer, have a good summer for AU, and then come back.
In one of the Division I state semifinals matchup, it was the Marquette Hilltoppers and the Muskego Warriors. And Muskego's forward, Matty Farner, carries his team in the first half. There he is, getting the fast break layup. Hilltoppers guard Job Alexander continues his hot play. Watch as he maneuvers his way through the defense. Matty Farner gets the job done inside and now outside as he knocks down the jump shot, putting his team up four. Marquette defense will force this turnover that leads to this highlight reel dunk by Nolan Wright. We go into halftime all tied up at 30. The Hilltoppers establish the post with Ryan Coffey as he shows off his Tim Duncan-like footwork on the block. Classic 8 Conference Player of the Year Caleb Wagner would get busy in the second half, folks, as he pulls up over the defender. Job Alexander on the run like Jay-Z and Beyonce as he goes to work like Rihanna. My main man, Caleb Wagner, turns it up in the second half. He buries the tray. Muskego takes a 7-point lead. Wagner finishes the game with 25 points. But Mr. Alexander does his best to keep Marquette in his game. He gets this tough layup to drop before fouling out with 14 points. But everything was going Muskego's way in this one. Caleb somehow gets this crazy pass to Tommy Anderson. He gets the basket plus the foul. Muskego wins 62-54.
Muskego's a very good team, and they took advantage of our mistakes, and you know they came out on top today. And again, I can't say how much I'm proud of the two gentlemen and the rest of our seniors for what they've accomplished this year.